Hey you guys, and welcome to another video. So today nga po is I'm going to share to you my subjects sa first year. You will learn today kung ano pwede natin i-expect sa subjects and what are we going to learn, what are we going to expect sa subjects sa first year. This is very helpful, especially for those who are incoming first year this August. So if you're interested, please keep on watching. So by the way, I'm Jeremiah and I upload law school and law student related vlogs. If you are new to this channel, please don't forget to click subscribe and click the notification bell so to be na subscribe. Or you can just simply click here in the circle dyan sa my corner. So, let's get to the video. So, hi nga po and welcome to another video. So, yun na nga. Today, I'll be sharing to you my subjects po sa first year since I am a first year law student. And nung pumasok ako sa law school, I have no idea kung ano bang mga magiging subjects ko. Until nung nakita ko na yung subject load ko for first year. But I have no idea kung ano bang pwede ko matutunan sa mga subjects na to. Kasi wala akong mga pwedeng mapagtanungan kung ano bang mga pwede kong i-expect sa mga subjects na to. And we will be talking about those things para naman po I can help those students, those aspiring law students para at least may mga overview na kayo kung anong magiging lessons nyo sa law school, especially sa mga first year. So, let's start! Okay, guys, first subject ko po is civil law. So, ang title po ng subject ngayon is Persons and Family Relations. So, ano nga ba ang pwede nating ma-expect sa subject na ito? Ano po ba ang pwede nating matutunan sa Persons and Family Relations? So, ang Persons and Family Relations po ay under po siya ng civil law. So, ano po ang civil law? Sa civil law po is matutunan natin yung relationship ng government at ng tao, tsaka tao at tao. The civilian people. So, what are those things na pwede nating makomit against sa mga kapwa natin tao? Kung ano natin pwedeng ma-commit against them or what they can commit against us. Kung anong pwede natin ma-commit against the government and the government against us. Parang ganun po. And you will learn po sa civil law yung mga about sa laws. You will learn eventually that laws are prospective and not retroactive or unless stated otherwise. Meaning po, yung law po natin dito sa Philippines are prospective. Meaning they are looking forward and not looking backwards. If you committed a crime from the past na wala pang law punishing it, then you cannot be punished by that crime. You'll be considered innocent for the crime because wala pa pong laws na pinapataw para sa crime na yun. So, you will be learning more about those things sa civil law. Also, sa civil law din, you will also learn about how to count dates sa contracts because contracts are still part of civil law. Kasi yung civil law, guys, marami siyang subtopics like property, succession, family relations. Ang dami pa po. But for first year, we're talking about persons and family relations. Also, you will be learning po sa civil law family relations, the family code. You will be discussing there yung requirements for marriage, yung mga requisites, yung mga grounds for nullity of marriage, yung voidability po, everything about marriage, relationships will be discussed po sa civil law, sa persons and family relations. So far, nasa family relations po kami ngayon and we are discussing requirements for marriage. Kung sino lang pwede mo pakasal and ang kasal is for sino lang between, yung mga requirements if you're going to file for marriage. And guys, there are a lot of things pa na pwedeng i-discuss sa civil law. Just think of this ha, na yung relationship mo sa tao, anything, basta pag ganun, that's under civil law. Hindi siya except yung mga crimes that are punishable by the revised penal code, so nasa criminal na po yun. Next subject po is criminal law. So, for first year, first sem, we have criminal law 1. So, nasa book 1 kami. And guys, ano pa expect natin sa criminal law na subject? Of course, sa criminal law po, is i-discuss dito kung ano ba ang definition ng crimes. There are types of crimes, na crimes committed by fault or culpa, tsaka yung may intent, may malice, or dolo. Don't worry, you'll be discussing that one sa criminal law nyo. Overall po, sa criminal law, I tell you, it's a long na subject. I would say, mahirap siyang subject din. Siguro may ibang nasa law school na and they find it easy. But for me po, I find it difficult because there are a lot of things po talaga sa criminal law na kailangan mong i-familiarize and kailangan mo po na i-memorize. Kasi po sa criminal law, for example, you will learn ha sa criminal law na hindi lahat ng crimes are considered crime sa law. For example, may crime na nakomit. In our eyes, as ordinary people na walang alam sa law, we can say, we can judge directly that is a crime. But if we're going to base that one sa laws po natin sa Philippines, if hindi kompleto yung mga requisites tsaka elements for it to be considered a crime, then that is not considered a crime. So, if you're going to think about it, there are a lot of analysis talaga and there are a lot of considerations that you have to consider for you to say that is a crime committed. Ang dami pong kailangan nating i-consider sa criminal law and yun po yung i-discuss nyo sa criminal law. All the requisites, all the grounds, all the elements para makonsider siya na crime. And also, there are also things na i-discuss sa criminal law. For example, those justifying circumstances, mitigating circumstances, exempting na circumstances. So those things, i-discuss po yan sa criminal law. So justifying circumstances are those actuations that are in accordance with the law. Yung wala siyang criminal liability. And yun po, yung mga mitigating circumstances. When we say mitigating circumstances, yung circumstances na imbis na you'll be given the penalty na, for example ha, para mas madali siyang maintindihan. For example, the highest level of the penalty is this one. But since you were able to qualify, so instead of having this penalty, so you will be given this penalty instead. For example, because you surrendered or something like that. So those are mitigating circumstances. So there are a lot of things pa that you will learn sa criminal law. And I tell you guys, it's not an easy subject, but it's very interesting na subject. You'll be reading some cases, landmark cases, jurisprudence about sa mga articles under the RPC or the Revised Penal Code. And I tell you po, you'll be like reading a novel na very interesting. Yun po yung mga usually ma-expect nyo po sa criminal law. After po na may nalaman ako about sa criminal law sa Philippines, ngayon, it's easier for me to watch balita sa TV because, di ba sa balita sa TV, there are a lot of crimes na reported there and you will understand now. You will say, ah, okay, yeah, that is blah, blah, blah. You will be able to understand all the crimes na binabalita po sa TV. So I tell you, this one is an interesting but it's not an easy subject. Next po na subject is we have the constitutional law. So we have constitutional law ngayon. And yes, of course, what to expect sa constitutional law. Ito na subject will be discussing the fundamental law of the land, fundamental law of the Philippines, which is our constitution, Constitution 1987. Dito po i-discuss yung transitions or yung iba't ibang constitutions that we had for the past years, sorry, for the past decade. Ang layo na po ng mga nirating ng ating mga constitution. Ang dami na po na naging change ng constitution natin. For the record, we already have 5 constitutions po dito sa Philippines. And yung present po natin ngayon is the 1987 constitution. So, you will learn kung bakit ang dami nating constitution from the past until today. And you will learn kung bakit nagkaroon ng 1987 constitution. Ano bang mga pangyayaring naganap kung bakit nagkaroon tayo ng daming constitution. Also, you have to expect that in this subject, you'll be discussing all the provisions sa constitution. And you will learn po kung gaano kaimportante ang constitution natin sa Philippines. If you're going to watch the balita on news, all the laws or the statutes that are passed or yung mga planong mga bills na pinapas ng Congress, lahat po ng ganun, if you will learn lang po sa Constitution, if it is in conflict with the Constitution, then you will know that it will never be passed po. Ganito katindi ang Constitution natin sa Philippines. So anything, any bill, any laws that are in conflict with the Constitution, that will be denied and considered null and void. So far sa mga subjects namin dito sa law school, mas interesado ako sa constitution namin na subject. Because in this subject, I learned that ganito pala talaga ang constitution ng Philippines. Pag may nabalita na bagong ipapasa ng mga laws by the Congress, I can just say na parang hindi yan, parang malabo yan because that is against the constitution. Parang ganun guys. And also, dito sa subject, you will also learn kung anong powers ng ating government. You will learn that the government has a police power, eminent domain, and taxation na power. So those three are the fundamental powers of our government. So you will learn kung bakit may ganito tayo na policy sa Pilipinas, there are people will say, "Uy, this is against my right." May mga reklamo tayo ng ganito sa Philippines, but we don't know, we don't realize na these policies pala are considered police power. And these are valid laws, even if it regulates our rights and our rights sa property, right as people. So yun, you will learn a lot po sa constitution. Lahat ng powers ng government, lahat ng powers ng ating constitution or the constitution itself. Next naman po na subject is the statutory construction. So statutory construction po, this one is, so far I'm finding it, para sa akin nga, confusing, and siguro I'm still in the adjustment period pa for this subject. But ano nga ba ang ma-expect natin sa STATCON or statutory construction? Dito po, you will learn how to make a law, a batas. So how to construct, how to interpret the law. How to interpret the law according to the framers, according sa paggawa ng mga nasa Congress. You will learn how to understand, to interpret the law here in the Philippines through this statutory construction. If the law is parang ambiguous, mahirap siyang intindihin, then there are things po, there are ways how to interpret the law according to its purpose nung ginawa siya ng mga framers, ng mga lawmakers. And so far, sa statutory construction namin, nahirapan ako. I'm not sure, baka sa inyo guys, you will find this easy na subject, but so far for me, I'm kinda cramming pa po sa subject na to. I just hope that I can eventually adjust to this subject and eventually get higher na grades for this subject. My next next subject, my fifth subject is legal profession. So, legal profession, what can we learn sa legal profession? Of course, about the profession sa pagka-lawyer, sa pagka-attorney, pagka-officer of the court. So, you will learn there kung ano bang mga requirements para maging attorney. If you are eligible to become attorney or are you qualified to become attorney? So, what are those qualifications? So, you will learn in this subject. Aside from the qualifications po, you will also learn kung bakit meron tayong LEB na agency ngayon, kung saan ba tayo talaga directly under sa government, especially yung mga lawyers, saan ba sila under? Are they under the president? Are they under the Congress? Are they under the judiciary? So you will learn that po sa legal profession. Also, you will learn in this subject yung sa hierarchy po ng judiciary. Mula sa first level course po sa MTC, MCTC, tapos pupunta sa RTC, tapos Court of Appeals, tapos Supreme Courts, you will learn po yung process, especially po sa mga appellate courts. You will learn a lot of those things dito po sa subject na ito. I-discuss din po dito kung saang provision sa Constitution tayo papasok. Yung course ng Juris Doctor or yung dati, yung Bachelor of Law, kung saan siya under sa Constitution, lahat po i-discuss po dito. So pati yung pagbigay ng PhilSAT, lahat ng issues about sa admission test for law schools, i-discuss dito kung anong nangyari, kung bakit tayo karoon ng PhilSAT. So lahat po i-discuss po siya dito. For my last subject po is legal research. What are the things that pwede nating ma-expect na ma-learn sa legal research? So according to the introduction of our professor, so in this subject, you will learn how to conduct research for those people who are in question sa law. So in other words, you will learn how to conduct researches. Yun po, yung mga in question po sa law. So far, we have discussed about persons who are in question of law. For example, sa grounds po na impeachment, tapos sa quo warranto, parang ganun. And I know there are a lot of things pa po na kailangan namin discuss. So far, hindi pa kami na-discuss yung sa grounds. We were just given the introduction kung paano ma-impeach ang isang officer, who are those impeachables, tapos who are those officers na pwede mag-qualify sa kuwaranto, parang ganun. According to our professor, there are a lot of things but that we are going to discuss. Yun, so far yun lang ata yung may bibigay ko ngayon about sa legal research. And you will learn pa po a lot sa subject na to. So, yun lang guys. So far, I have 6 na subjects. I have civil law, I have criminal law, constitutional law, statutory construction, legal research, and legal profession. So, I just hope na you learned something today, and at least I was able to give you some overview or a picture of what to expect pagpasok nyo po sa law school. Yun, if you have other questions po, then please don't forget to comment that one below. If I said something wrong, please comment that one also. Let me know. Yun po, if you have other suggestions for my future videos, kung may mga gusto kayong itanong, tapos gusto nyo pong masagot ko po. Again, I encourage everyone to please follow me in my social media accounts, sa Instagram, sa Facebook, sa YouTube. And also, I have my Gmail account there if you have any other questions. And I was planning to make a Q&A. So if you are following me sa Instagram, you may send those questions via DMs or you can just write that one sa below po dito sa comment section. If you like this video, if you find this video helpful, please don't forget to leave a thumbs up and share this video to your classmates, to your future classmates sa law school. And yes, don't forget to click subscribe and click the notification po sa tabi na subscribe. So I think that's it for today and I will see you on my next video. Thank you.